Hello, in the second Bootstrap 3 tutorial, I'll show you step-by-step how to build your choice of three fully responsive navigations: default, static top, or fixed top. So as you see, the navigation begins to collapse on mobile device size viewports and becomes horizontal as the viewport width increases. In the first video, we set up our product using Bootstrap's basic HTML, and we'll add our navbar to that index.html page. Okay, so I've opened index.html and Notepad++ on the left side of the screen, and I'll launch the page in Google Chrome's browser on the right side of the screen. Okay, first we'll create the default navbar, then I'll show you how to modify that to create either the static top or fixed top navbars. Okay, first we're going to comment out our navbar so we know where it's located in the code. Right above our hello world text there. Next, we're going to create a container so that the navbar does not extend horizontally across the full width of the screen. And then we're going to create a div class for the default navbar. And I'm going to be sure to include role navigation next here to help with accessibility and SEO. And then finally, after that, we're gonna save it. And then I'll go to my browser here on the right and hit F5 to refresh it. And we see in a second that we created a container. Okay, I've sped up the video to save some time, but what we've created here is a collapsible navigation button that expands and collapses as the viewport width increases or decreases, and the three icon bars will give us the three horizontal bars within the button. And in a moment here, I will show you the end product, which is a button on the right with three bars coming up on the right. There you go. All right, and next we create our brand. It will be fully functional once we hover over that, as the button is fully functional as well. Okay, next we create our links by creating an unordered list. And in a moment here, we'll take a look at what that looks like when it is toggled and expanded. Okay, now we're going to add another item to our menu. This time it's going to be a drop-down list, which will toggle. And we'll create three sub-menu items under this drop list. Action 2 and action 3. And here is the drop list that we just created. So you see it is fully functional. Okay, and there you have your default navbar. To convert this to the static top navbar, just go ahead and move your container down above the hello world and add the class navbar static top. I'm gonna go ahead and save that, and then I'll refresh my browser on the right and see what that looks like. All right, and then we have a static top navbar. Okay, now to convert this from static top navigation to fixed top, it's really just a matter of changing the class from navbar static top to navbar fixed top. I'll go ahead and control S to save this, and on the right I'll click F5 again to refresh it. Now you see here the hello world text is now hidden behind our fixed top navigation, so we'll need to correct that problem by building in some padding and attaching a new style sheet just for that purpose. Okay, I've fixed the padding problem by attaching an additional style sheet, which I called navbar.fixed. I stored that in my CSS folder, and the CSS itself is as simple as creating 70 pixels of padding from the top. So that is all it took to correct this, and now you see the navbar remains fixed to the top with the appropriate padding when I scroll. Alright, well, I hope you've enjoyed watching the video, and be sure to comment, rate, and subscribe.